Welcome to Sri Swami Engineering Academy. Today we are going to learn about the bypass factor of heating and cooling coil. Now let us see how it is called as bypass factor. Let us say I am having a cooling coil, okay, and this is what a container through which some amount of air is going, okay, and same amount of air is coming out. Let us say some amount of air is going like this and it goes through the cooling coil, but you cannot assure that total amount of air which is coming from here will pass through or will come in contact with the heating coil. Some may be going from here to here without come in contact with the heating coil. That is nothing but the bypass air. So to increase the contact, we'll have some meshing and all. We'll have to increase the heat transfer again. You are having other methods, that is, you can have here increasing the surface area and all. But some amount of air will directly go from here to here, and some amount of air from here will come in contact with the heating coil. Or if you take a cooling coil, that will be the same one. Okay. Now to analyze this, to have a bypass factor, let us consider this. Let us say 1 kg of moist air, I am talking about the moist air, 1 kg of moist air having a dry bulb temperature of TdB1, that is dry bulb temperature of incoming air, will pass through this tube. Let us say x kg is going to be bypassed, and remaining means this is 1 kg is going, x kg is bypassed, that means remaining is 1 minus x kg will remain here, and that will pass over the heating coil, and both the streams will come here, again come together, that is mixed together, and that will form again x kg, 1 minus x kg, that will come to the 1 kg, again this 1 kg will come outside. That means what? 1 kg is coming inside, 1 kg is going outside, but x kg will bypass and 1 minus x kg will pass through the coil. Now let us balance the energies here. Now if you want to balance, I will take before the cooling coil and after the cooling coil I will take. Okay. Now if you balance this, what will happen? I will take sensible heating because there is no water added or removal here. So sensible heating can be taken as MCP delta T or MCPT. That is nothing but sensible heat. So x kg of air that will directly go out, that means it has the temperature equal to what? TdB1. And 1 minus x kg will pass over the coil. It has a temperature of coil. Let us say the temperature of coil is say TdB3. Let us say TdB3. Or you can take TD3 or T3 or T1 and T2 like that. Okay. So 1 minus x kg will come in contact with the coil. It takes the temperature of coil and it comes here. X kg will directly come here without taking or without incoming contact with the coil. That means it has a temperature equal to incoming air. Okay. So I will balance that. That is what x, that is m, x kg and a mass, x mass into Cp of moist air into temperature. What is that? TdB1. That is mCp delta T. That is what you can have the sensible heat. Plus this 1 minus x kg m again Cp of moist air multiplied by what is the temperature of this air? This air comes in contact with the cooling heating coil, that means it has a temperature of this TdB3. So this is TdB3, that is equal to the this one. So mixing these two streams comes out with this one. So what will the mass now? Mass is 1 kg now into Cp of moist air, and what is the temperature now? TdB2. If you see here, CPM, CPM, and CPM, can be taken outside or common, I will directly make it cancelled. Sorry, CPM is to be cancelled. CPM is to be directly cancelled. What is remaining here is you will have X TDB1 plus, I will multiply this, that is TDB3 minus X TDB3 is equal to, you can have TDB2. Now let us take the X terms one side and remaining terms to other side. We will have X common from here, we will get TDB1, this is TDB1 minus TDB2 is equal to TDB2, sorry, this is TDB3, I think so, yes, sorry, TDB3, okay, is equal to TDB2, this will be here minus TDB3, correct? Now, X will be taken as TDB2 minus TDB3 upon TDB1 minus TDB3. Now if you see, the temperature of the heating coil is greater than the temperature of how? Air. And it is again the greater than the temperature of incoming air. That is, in this heating system, the highest temperature is this one. So if you see this highest temperature of this side, and this will come negative. So I will take a minus sign common here, and again minus sign common here. What you are getting here is, X is equal to, if I take minus sign common, then this will minus this minus this. You'll get this minus this. Okay? So we'll get TdB3 minus of TdB2 divided by TdB3 minus TdB1. This is, X is called bypass air, or it is also called as bypass factor. It is simply written as bypass factor. And you can write that this is simply T3 minus T2 divided by T3 minus T1. Okay? Now, the same concept, if you take a cooling coil, in that case, the bypass factor will be same, just you make the same jugglery and you find the bypass factor. In that case, that cooling coil has the lowest temperature than these two. That means you take T3 this side, you will get T2 minus T3, and this is T1 minus T3. That is nothing but the bypass factor. Now, we have seen what is the bypass factor of heating and cooling coil. This is the bypass factor of heating coil. You can write heating coil. This is the bypass factor of cooling coil. So if I want to have the efficiency of heating and cooling coil, efficiency of heating and cooling coil, what you are having? Efficiency means, you see, because of this bypass air, the total TdB, that is the temperature coming out, will not be equal to the temperature of coil. If total air will go through this, then the output temperature will be same as that of coil. That means, because of this bypass factor, your temperature is not coming with this equal. So that means, this will affect the output. So this is nothing but your factor which will not make this system 100% efficient. So this lagging is making this coil to be inefficient. So what is the efficiency of the coil? You can say efficiency of the heating coil, I will say, equal to nothing but 1 minus bypass factor. That is nothing but the efficiency of a heating coil. Or if you take the efficiency of a cooling coil, it is again 1 minus bypass factor. If you go for this, you can again make the jugglery. Don't try to remember this relation, try to remember main relation and this one. You will get all the things. What is this bypass factor of a heating coil? It is T3 minus T2 upon T3 minus T1. If you multiply this and add in this, what you are getting? 3 minus T1, okay, minus T3, minus of minus, you will get plus T2. So what you are getting here is T3 minus T1 minus, you will take like this. So it will be minus T3 plus T2 divided by T3 minus, you can have T1. So what you are getting here is, I will write here what you are getting. That is T3 gets cancelled, that is minus T1, this is plus T2. So it will be efficiency of a heating coil will be T2 minus T1 upon T3 minus T1. So that you are getting. Similarly, we'll get for a cooling coil, you put here, instead of this, you put here this one. So you will get a relation for a cooling coil. This is about the bypass factor of heating and cooling coil. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. In the next video, we will learn more about this, that is different processes, bypass factor, how bypass factor affects the different processes. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe.